we're gonna get started. First of all, I'd like to welcome you guys all to the parent meeting. We try to have one a year to answer a lot of questions about what we do with the organization. DECA, just to let you know, I've been a DECA advisor here for 20 years, and it's an amazing organization. It is absolutely, positively amazing to watch the young people just transition into young professionals, because that's what happens. And it doesn't matter whether they're into business or not. I always look at it this way. These kids took English, they took math, they took science, they took social studies, they might have even taken a foreign language, but they don't get a business course. So, if they don't get a business course in some schools, they'll go off to college, spend lots of thousands of dollars, and say, hey, I didn't really like English, that wasn't my thing, I don't want to be a Spanish major, so I must be a business major. And they get to college, and then they choose a major based on what they have no idea about. The great thing about having these kids have 9 different business courses in which they can choose from is they can make an informed decision if that's what they feel like they're connected to for a possible career choice. It's an amazing opportunity, both if they really dig in and go further with it, but to have 9 opportunities to take a business course. I have kids right now, so I have one. Here's Lori, Wendy and Ash. Her son is at the number one entrepreneurship school in the world. In the world. And he told me the other day that, right? And I saw him a couple weeks ago, and he said that he has a huge advantage. He just feels like he has a giant advantage. So that's what we try to do here. Give our random kids an advantage. We do that by competing against other schools. Right now, I have 27 kids who are taking an entrepreneurship course offered by Babson College. It costs $1,400 a kid to take it, and we found means to supplement it so they only have to pay $50. So we're giving these kids, on a daily basis, a first-class opportunity to explore the world of business. Now, along with that comes the competitions that we do, the community service that we do. We've raised over, you know, $3,000, $4,000. Let me tell you a story. I was at competition at the state conference last year, and they had a competition between who could raise the most money for muscular dystrophy, right? So these schools, there are probably 40, well, how many schools? 40, 50 at the state conference?
57, I think.
Everything from Manchester, Essex, to Westford Academy, to all these big affluent schools. And it came down to two schools, Whittingham and Tottenham. And between the two schools, they raised $2,000 in a matter of 4 hours because kids are reaching into their pockets and pulling out, oh my God, $5 to help somebody other than themselves. Because of that effort between Whittingham and Tottenham, the Massachusetts section of the MBA Association sent one of our Whittingham kids to Nationals to a leadership conference last year in Nashville, Tennessee. That's the kind of kid that we want. That's the kind of kid that you have raised. That's the kind of kid that I want to, and all of the instructors want to bring to the next level so that they have those opportunities and they are afforded different experiences. Unfortunately, going to a lot of these conferences does not work for us. But like I told the kids at a meeting earlier this week, I will not allow money to get in the way of somebody to have that experience. Whether it's work study, because I think the kids should help themselves, whether they work in a basketball game concession stand, they work in the Gateman concession stand over the summer, whether they're doing this Mattress Madness fundraiser, or they're getting an auction item, or they're securing a company for the home show. That all goes right back to them. It's not like a fundraiser where it goes to debt. Part of it does, but those kids that work the hardest are the kids that make out. I was lucky enough to employ 21 kids this summer at the Gateman stand. Okay? That's a lot of money. Now, what we made as a group, and as a together organization, was probably a couple $1,000s. But what I can put their account to compete was close to $6,000. For all those kids. So it provides opportunities. Also, a learning experience. They learn how to be these business people. They are coordinating these events. They are project managers in their classrooms with their instructors. It is an amazing opportunity. It is an amazing program. I couldn't feel more passionate about it. My father started in high school in 1974, started the program. And when he left in 1996, I picked up. And it's ironic enough that my first initial and his first initial is the same. So on my door it says, see Sylvia, but it's not my nameplate. And it's been in place right there since 1966. And when I go back and I talk to William DECA, it's a family and it's far-reaching more than you can ever imagine. Your child is in this family, it's almost for life. I hired them back as DECA teachers, as Miss Goulet. I had her in class of 2004. Or they're right now coaching a soccer game that a few of you should be at, because she's in class of 1999. And I know where they are, who the kids are. I have a kid in my advisory right now where I had her mother in DECA class. And when she had this young lady, when she was born, she sent me a picture of her, and now she's going to graduate this year as a senior. The family lives on. It is just part of the culture here at Wayham High School. We care about these kids when they're not with you. They have become part of us. And so this fundraiser is really to help them have those experiences that I have seen over the course of 20 years change. Not impact the life of some of these students, but change the life of some of these students beyond where I could ever tell you. One quick story before I introduce Ms. Maurice. I had a young lady, she graduated class of 2002, and she said she wanted to explore the world, but she was nervous because she had never been out of Wayham. So just by a fluke, she applied to the University of Hawaii. Guess what? She got in. She got into the University of Hawaii, and she says to me, Self, I can't go. Do you know how far away that is? I go, then why did you apply? She goes, because I never thought I would get in. It's just been my dream to go to Hawaii. I said, so you're going to stop yourself in your dream because you're a little nervous? I said, the best thing about Hawaii is you go, you go. You check it out, and if you don't like it, you come home. She never came home. She's the head of tourism on one of the islands. She got married 4 years ago and has a beautiful baby girl. That's what her life has turned out to be. But if she had just stayed and didn't have the confidence, and to this day I still talk to her. I still stay in touch with most of the kids in the program as I go by myself. But as they go on their lives, I never forget. And that's what makes this special. It is not like any other club organization. It is different. And I can't explain how, and I can't explain why, other than the fact that we're a family. And we care what happens to them now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 30 years from now, 21. So I'm going to turn it over to one of our DECA teachers. We have three. Ms. Maurice, come on up. I had to come out of the classroom, which stressed me out a little bit. I only teach a couple of classes. So, Ms. Maurice taught at Sandwich High School, and we used to compete against each other, and I knew what kind of teacher she was, and I knew she loved kids. Well, I couldn't leave my position as a DECA teacher unless I left it to someone who loves kids. So, I called her up, and I said, what you doing? And she said, I'm working at a coffee shop. I said, why? Because she loved teaching at Sandwich to raise her three kids. And I said, you want to come be a teacher? She goes, where? I said, with me. She says, with you? I said, yeah. She says, and you would be my boss. I said, yeah. And I'm going to teach all the classes that I absolutely love. I said, yes. And so I brought her along. Then Mr. Callie, another DECA teacher who's amazing. I watched him on a baseball field, coached my son and others. I coached with him, and I watched him with kids, and I said, you need to be a teacher, because you are amazing with kids. And he loves them just the way I do. So I went out and I got him to be a DECA teacher. And then finally in the back, for anybody, come on up. Miss Goulet, Miss I also was a softball coach here for 16 years. And it was a program also near and dear to my heart as DECA was. And Janine is probably the all-time most successful softball player that ever played for Wingham High School, but also the most successful pitcher that ever pitched for Bryan University. I didn't just put it out there, I said, what are you doing? Because I went out and I got this team because I knew they felt about kids the way I feel about kids. And Janine Goulet knows exactly about this program because she's competed. She has been a student in my class, and now she's able to bring all that experience that she had from an amazing business school like Ryan and bring it into the classroom for the kids. So it is not by chance that this is your DECA team. It is but on purpose that this is your DECA team. I went out and I built this team because I knew the one thing that's important to me is that they love kids. Everything after that falls into place, and that's the scheme that you have now. So, Ms. Maurice, I'm going to turn it over to you.
Well, I don't know how I follow that. We were presented with a unique opportunity by a custom fundraiser solutions, and the representative out of Boston is Jack Isaacs. And I had heard about Mattress fundraising. And since then, we don't ask our kids to sell candy bars or candles or wrapping paper because I personally don't need to buy closets. I don't know about you guys. And I'd much rather just give somebody the $20 bill and put it in their account and have all my big gift items for some time later on down the line. So I asked Jack to come and talk to us. The kids back there, our senior team, our project management team, last year sat in with Jack, listened to the story, listened to the success stories. You can see the pictures all around, and I'm sure Jack's going to talk to us about it, but it was intriguing, and we do sales, we do marketing, and I'm like, okay, and he goes, yeah, but I don't want you to do sales. And I'm like, wait a minute, everybody wants us to do sales, that's what we do. And he's like, nope, I just want you to market, spread the word, promote. I was like, oh, that's cool. And so I have Nate out there. Nate Nunetta is our project manager for the team. And he is supported by Zach Duffy, who's our assistant project manager, along with Alyssa Lacava, but unfortunately she's playing varsity volleyball right now. Right? Yes, it just started. So, and then their team consisted of Ryan Judge, and Adriana Adams, and the other seniors that are up there are working on another project we have going on, which is to work with Chef Greta to open a Viking cafe in the school store, which will be very cool along the bench. So with all that said, I was like, okay, we need to make a lot of money though, because they all want to go to California. I don't know if you've heard yet. I see DC is in Anaheim, and they're like, we're going. Not, and as Sylv, I don't know how many seats she booked on the plane. Last year she told us we were crazy for wanting 25-30. We filled them. So this year we're going for 25-30. She really thinks we're crazy, but they want them. And if you ask, you can't even say, I'm like, yeah, guys, well, we'll see. They're like, no, we're going. Am I right? So I'm like, well, let's get to work. But we also need a ton of money. I don't know if Joyce is here, but Kim Carmen in the back. Kim, can you just wave? He's the president of our booster club, and I think we were audited in a very positive outcome, but how much money goes into this organization on an annual basis?
Over
50, but and districts cost us about $30,000 to take 120 kids. States cost another $28,000 to $30,000 to take 75 kids, and nationals cost us
a lot of money.
So we run the organization on an annual basis. So we have a handful of big fundraisers. Mr. Kelly handled the drive for your school last spring, and we raised $6,000 in that one day. We had the home show, which we all worked on. Mr. Carmen is really the one who spearheads that. The kids do all the work, though, and we raised $9,000 last spring. Two-day event. Months of work, but two-day event. And then the auction, spaghetti supper, been going on for over 20-plus years, and we raised about $7,000 that one day. So Jack came to us with another opportunity, and I don't know if you saw the figures walking around, but we're looking to raise, guys. How much do you want to raise?
$7,500 to $10,000.
Say it again?
$7,500 to $10,000.
Next Saturday. That's what they want. Not Mr. Kelly, not Ms. Goulet, not Sylv, not myself. They want to raise $7,500 to $10,000. And that will really help offset a lot of the cost. Jack has broken down the commission plan for them. They know, I don't know if we're going to cover that today. But let's just say for every person he'll tell you, he doesn't want us to sell, I'm not going to tell his story, he'll tell it. But basically it's just putting the yard signs in our yard. It's handing out those flyers to anybody. 1 out of 10, is that the stats? 1 out of 10 people are looking for mattresses. Zach, what's your mom, you've been working on it for a month for referrals. What'd you do?
So my mom works at Toby Hospital, and I asked her if she knew anyone that would actually want to be interested in buying one. So she asked a few people at her work, and it turns out her son, employee's son, is a real estate agent and into like flipping houses and putting new furniture into all of them. So he's interested in buying mattresses for all these houses that he's working on at a discounted price of 30 to 50% off. So it's a win-win.
We got lots of real estate agents around. Just go drop off your flyers. Your kid's name's going to be on it. If that person walks in and buys a mattress, your kid gets $25 right off the bat. And then we split I think it's $50 for twin, $75 for full and queen. Might be wrong on this. $100 for the king. And then there's commission on pillows and headliners and more. Oh my. So. So, I'm really excited about this. It's our baby for the class of 2017. It's their gift to DECA, hopefully $7,500 to $10,000 in the pockets. They stamped 280 envelopes to send out to all the families, potential DECA members. They've done the emails, they've sent out the press releases. So I want to turn it over to Jack so he can really tell you what he's going to do for us. And the few things he's asking of us, which isn't much. So, Jack.
That was awesome.
It's not in the way.
Necessary evil.
And that's why a lot of people really like this, because it is one of the easiest fundraisers that anybody's ever done. And but then my job tonight is really not to sell you a mattress, but if you are in the market, you'll definitely come and check it out. But there's a lot of people that couldn't be here tonight because there are a lot of other lifestyle things going on. So the biggest takeaway from this kind of a meeting is really just to talk to your friends and your coworkers, your neighbors about this event. For those who couldn't make it. So hopefully everybody has a pack in their hands and a pack of flyers. I'm going to talk a little bit about that. Has anybody ever heard of a mattress fundraiser? At a store? Or at another store? Another school? No? Okay. This is kind of new down to this area, but we've been doing this for a long time. I'm just going to give you a little bit of background then. I wish I came up with the idea, but I didn't. This company actually started in 2005. Custom fundraising solutions. My buddy Joe started this in Cleveland, Ohio, with just one location. We now do these events all over the country. We're in 68 locations all across the United States. So every single week, we do these mattress events. I started in Massachusetts. I opened up Massachusetts. And I'll give you a little bit of background about me, too. In May of 2012, so we've been doing this for 4.5 years now. Before I actually got into mattress fundraising, I actually opened up my own business. Right out of college, I opened up juice and nutrition bars inside health clubs. And I did that for 21 years. So I actually built up inside Gold's Gyms, inside of, back then it was called Badly Total Fitness and Quality Spas. I don't know if anybody's heard of those, but I had three of them going. I sold one, I gave the second one away, and I walked away from a third one when I heard about this opportunity. So I know it does sound kind of strange. I mean, does anybody think it's kind of weird? Yeah. Mattress fundraising. It is kind of strange. When my friend Joe started this, a short and clip note version, right out of school, he was fundraising. He didn't like pushing products on the people that they didn't really need or want, like we heard cookie dough or wrapping paper or
candles.
Candy bars, candles, sunscreen is actually really interesting. When you told me sunscreen in Cleveland is like the third or fourth cloudiest city before buying sunscreen. Not because they had a need or want, but because they knew the kid that played football or was on the deck. I call it the sympathy purchase or the guilt purchase. So he actually got out of that, and he started furnishing model homes, and this will all kind of come around, it's like a Seinfeld episode, and I'm making sense right now, but it'll be funny later. Just checking. And basically how that worked in these model homes, he would fill these model homes, there's a contract stipulated, whenever there was a sale in a model home, you could actually have a furniture model home sale. So he would put up signs and banners in the neighborhoods, and he was a very lucrative industry. And in that industry, he actually wrote a business journal article about Furniture Today. They are the Bible of the furniture and bedding business industry. And they did a survey of the U.S. population. 14.8% of the United States is actually in the market for mattress. Yes, that's a huge number. 9.9% actually make a purchase. 10% of the population buys a mattress every single year. You heard that number. That's just a fact. That's a 100-year-old fact that hasn't changed. So if you take the population of Wareham, how many people know how many people live in? Like 20,000, say?
22,000.
22,000. So math makes that's an easy one. What's 10% of that?
That's me too.
2,500 people are buying mattresses. So they either go to like a store or they come to the school. And hopefully, we're not going to get all 2,500 people that are looking to buy mattresses to come here next Saturday. But if we get a small percentage of those, you can really knock this out of the park. The global record, I don't know if you all can see that, but I'll show you some pictures. Right now, we work with over 60 high schools here locally in Massachusetts. So I grew up in Maine, and I played football when I was in high school. So I went up to the coach, and I talked to him, just kind of let him talk to you. We thought I was a little crazy at first, and we're thinking, you know, never forget. I'm so glad you trusted me to take this on. Because we made them, I don't know if you can see it, but $5,000 right out of the gate. The best thing about this is that nobody in the room here, the parents, the students, nobody has to try to go out and sell anything. It's nothing like that. The biggest takeaway from this is just promoting, creating awareness. That's probably the biggest one. I heard Taunton High School mention, they've done it 3 years. They just had their third annual one back in June of 2016. $10,650. One day, on a Saturday from 10 to 5. That's a lot of candy bars. There's a few others, just since, we, since we're here. If you want to go check out some of the ones around here, it's pretty cool. Norwood High School, I just noticed up there. They just had their fourth annual one back in September. It was like a couple weeks ago. They've already made over another $5,000, $22,000. So add another $5,000 onto that and what they made with it. Here's Grafton High School, a little further out. This is for the class of 2016. They made $8,500 doing these mattress covers. Here's Natick High School, their third annual, another $5,000 doing Bridgewater, East Bridgewater High School. This is great. Band and chorus, 9 piece and $475 a minute. We're trying to break the local record. Marshfield set, their second annual one is coming up in November 6th, but they made $12,000 on a Saturday. That would help. This is pretty cool. 65 kids. Usually how it works is that the more students that are in the program that we work with, because we work exclusively with high schools and a few churches. So like once the football team gets it, or the band gets it, or the DECA group gets it, nobody else in the district gets this mattress fundraiser event. It becomes very coveted. 65 kids in a band, this is their third year doing it, $23,000. Isn't that awesome? That's their third year doing it. Their first year was 16. Their second year was 11. That's their third year. So you saw a picture out in the front there of the Allen Estherville Band. 750 kids that play band. You'll see it out front, $25,000. So when their record was broken, they kind of got together and said, we want it back. And they did. Their following year, October 15, $27,000. So they made, in the 4 days, over $80,000. That was just broken last week. October 7th, 2 weeks, a couple weeks. 167 mattresses. I don't know if you can see it, but can you see all that number? $28,000, 164 mattresses were sold that day in one day. And the reason why it works is because 10% of the population buys a mattress every year. Another interesting statistic and a fact, the time that somebody is in the market for a mattress and that transaction happens, on average, there's a 72-hour window. So if I'm a retailer, like a Jordan's, Sleepy's, Bob's, whatever, they have to catch your eye or your ear within that 72 hours, or they're going to lose you as a customer for another like 7, 8, 9, 10 years until you're in the market again. So that's still the rules, and you put on television, I guarantee you, you're going to see a mattress commercial on television. You ever seen one? Right? Home on the radio, AM, FM, doesn't matter, I don't care what you want. You go home and type in mattress on your computer, you'll probably see the whole right side of your screen filled with ads for mattresses. 10% within 72 hours. So what we do, we don't do any commercials on television. What we do is we rely on the students, the family, really, to promote it, spread the word. So what we do is, if you've ever been into a Sleepy's or a Jordan's or a Bob's, we bring the showroom to you, to the school. Can you all kind of see what that looks like? So we bring in 24 beds for people to try out. We have a whole row of like firmer beds, a whole row of softer beds, a whole row of, yeah, sure, go for it. Thanks. That's awesome. I can tell this is going to be a good day. So we bring in 24 beds, and there's like pocket foils, regular foils, gel beds, memory foam, gel, everything that you can think of at a store or walk into a store, we have. The only thing we don't have, I would say, is water beds and crib size mattresses, but that's okay. If you think about your own home, how many mattresses do you have in your own home? It's probably more than one, right? Three, four, maybe. Anybody have more than three, maybe four or five beds? A few. Like, if you're starting a family, you get that crib mattress, right, look the bars on it. They get out of that a few years from now, they go up to college maybe, or they get another twin or full. People that are remodeling homes, buying homes, selling homes, they're getting mattresses. People that are getting mattresses, buy mattresses, the people that get divorced, get mattresses. There's a lot. There's 25,000 people that live in Wareham, so 10%, 2,500 people. So our job really is to talk to as many people as we can and really build this up, because the circus is in town for one day. And the big how you do that is by what you have in your hands. It's really just a, like a, I call it a kickoff packet. The number one most important thing is why, how we get all these big numbers. Number one most important thing is everybody, every student finds, every family finds at least, I don't know, I'm going to stop at one or two or three, a few people that are looking to buy a mattress and get them to come to the school and get them a personal referral flyer like you have in your hands. You guys knock it out of the park. If there are, how many students do we got working this again? 70, 80?
At least.
At least. Yeah. So if there are 70, if everybody does that one thing, finding one person, you're already at $7,000. It's just how our numbers work. 85% of the people that come in with these. 15% of our sales come from like a sign that you might see outside or in the mattress bathroom or a banner or something. A typical sport is only like 5% of what we need. So at the very bottom of this, you're gonna see a $50 off coupon too. So when you do talk to people or texting people, you can say your text. Good. I can't wait to show you something in just a few minutes. It's going to really help with this too. But it's a $50 off coupon. So when they do come in, because we always ask everybody, when people come in, we have a whole team that comes in and does our showroom, they set it up. We have another team that comes in and does the selling of the mattresses, the handling of the transactions. We set up the customers, the pickups or delivery, and I'll talk a little bit about that in a second. So they're totally hands off. We just need you, we need them to help, or you guys to help us let everybody know about this one day event. A lot of students, they take actually pictures of that and they'll text it out to people because a lot of people come in with their cell phones, like I talked about, and this works just as well. Somebody can come in and buy just a mattress, they get the whole set. And what we do, because we come to the school, we don't have any overhead like a store. So we're offering 30, 40, up to 50% off of what people are buying anyway. And they all start, just so you know, they all start with twins, fulls, queens, kings, California kings. Twin Weeks. I just got a call today from Pembroke High School. They're having their third annual this coming Saturday. So I just got a call from somebody. Somebody talked to somebody from a hospital. They're in 15 mattresses. Pretty neat. Lynn Classical, no, they're around here somewhere, but Lynn Classical High School, 32 girls on a softball team. One of the parents was in a meeting just like this one. He came to the event. He happened to be the CEO of his local shelter. So they bought 50 mattresses, 50 twin mattresses. A couple of weeks later, another email for another 50. Like a month later, another 50. They just keep getting checks because somebody opened up their mouth and they made them aware. It's all about awareness. So that's the part. This sheet is really just kind of like a brain teaser, just to kind of help think about once you think about you. Do just don't prejudge them. You're gonna be shocked and amazed how many people would say, "Hey, I could actually replace a mattress in my home." I mean, I always think about like Thanksgiving that's coming up. You get like maybe 10 people up at the table, and you ask the question, "Could anybody replace a mattress in your home?" 1 out of 10 will say me, but they're not going to come to you and say, "Hey, I need a high mattress. Can you help me out?" That's weird. On this third page, it's really just kind of just help to help get the word out. Ways to help do that. Whether it's tweeting, social media, we're getting a lot of results with social media. If you guys use Facebook, I really highly encourage everybody, even if you know these things, if you go to Facebook, go to Custom Fundraising Solutions Boston. And if you click on events, you're going to see your event there. Like it and say that you go. And then just share it with all of your contacts. If you know somebody that in California, Florida, Idaho, in Bridgewater, somebody came in from Kentucky. They just moved there, but they were having their band mattress fundraiser out in Kentucky. So the woman that came in, she bought 3 mattresses, and the kid made $100, and the band made their money too. And nothing's more motivating than a little bit of money too, and I'm going to talk about that also in a second. Everybody that comes in and buys a mattress and refers your son or daughter's name on these flyers. Because we always ask everybody, how do you hear about us? Oh, I got Nathan gave me a flyer with his name on it. So DECA is credited for everything, not just the mattress that we sell, but for everything that we sell. We sell, as you said, we have 9 high-end luxury premium pillows that are for sale too. I know it's hard to see them, but if you actually come up afterwards and you look at them, these are all memory foam pillows. These are scented aromatherapy, like Camomile. Peppermint, lavender, cool memory foam, gel memory foam, those large holes. These are really cool, literally. These large holes create small holes on the edges to support the head. That's your head, basically. And they make money on every single thing that we sell. These are guaranteed for 5 years. They come with dust mite resistant annual mold covers, which is kind of cool. So we have 9 luxury high-end pillows. So somebody may not need a mattress, but benches, they maybe use a pillow because they want it either, they need one, but they just want to help support. They make money on everything. Whether it's a frame, pillow, a couple frames. These are awesome. We've got 4. If you know anybody that snores or has acid reflux, watches TV in bed, eats in bed, sleeps in bed. Those are awesome. They, you know, they go up and down, keep them up. Zero gravity. Even if you don't need one, just come and check it out. Those are pretty cool. They are the hottest trend in the mattress industry. And people come to us and they save thousands and thousands of dollars. And they start at like, I think, $4 or $5.99. Change of life. So everyone that comes in, they mention, I use the example of Nathan, you'll see it on there. Not only does the DECA program get credit for every single mattress that's sold, but they'll get $25 cash. I don't know if you're going to the spot, but I forget how that's working. Mo, can you come refresh my memory?
What's up?
The cash that goes into their pockets or their accounts?
So it's going directly into their accounts so that we can hopefully get everybody's districts paid if everybody works really hard. And like I said, the money that the club would have made, we're splitting it right in half. So if Liz sells a mattress, a twin, or refers somebody to buy a twin, then she ends up with 25 plus half of 50. She ends up with $50 right into her account.
Yeah, 2 mattresses, we don't care how it adds up. Two people is 25 is $50. 3 people, $100. I mean, that would certainly help. 5 is $200 in cash, in addition to what we give for whatever mattress is sold. We don't care if it's least expensive. They start at $199. And they range up into what you'll see in a store for over $5,000. We have the same bed for $2,000, $2,100. These are really, really nice. At Marshall High School, East Bridgewater, they had several students that got 10 people. And
that's $500.
In addition to everything else. So that's a nice incentive. Also, we take all those referrals at the end of the, when it's over, and when we present their big check, and about 10 days after the event, we take all those referrals and they put them into a hat, and we do like a drawing, so you'll see that at the bottom too. So when we hit 35, we have a pair of Bose headphones I have on the table there. When we hit 45, that's a Bose sound off. Those are awesome. 55 is a 23 inch flat screen TV. I love giving those away. When we do 70, which should be easy at this group, we wrap up another, what is it, a wave rating. Close to $4.99. Love giving stuff away. So our biggest thing is creating awareness again. At the back of the table, there's a whole bunch of signs back there. We've got 100 of them. Please take one home and put it in your dorm. If you know, if your place of business will allow you to take one, if you have a sister or a brother, a neighbor, if they go in their yards. And we've got these, those are the signs that come back on the day of the event. And I'll talk a little bit about that in a second too. We've got a whole table, we've got 100 of these posters. These great, they go up into like places of business, obviously, like where people get their hair done, people get their nails done, fitness centers, I don't know, any of the community, sub shops, pizza places. The Norman High School, like a student that they put up a poster, they allowed you, if they allow you to put up a poster, they're probably allowed you to put up a stack of flyers too. And every time, I remember this, she was telling me this, every time a pizza went out for a delivery in Norwood High School, they take a personal referral flyer went out with every single pizza.
Okay.
Marshall High School, that was pretty cool. They have Roach Brothers. So every time, at the last week of the event, every time a shopping bag went out that store, a flyer went out with every single bag.
That's a great
one.
Everybody sticks to a mattress. It may be their time. If it is, get them to come. That's the biggest thing that we're asking people to do. What else do we got? So on the day of the event, we got 282. have a business? Or do you know someone who has a business? We have these are going to be going up. So on the day of the event, we're going to have some banners. That's pretty cool, huh?
That's great.
That's amazing.
I think we got 3 or 4 of these.
Awesome.
Okay.
We could put one.
Pretty fancy. And so we hold up, so the kids, really the only thing we ask them is they're here on the day of the event. I think we're going to have different intersections around town or high visibility locations. Pull in the signs and the banners and wearing these mattress costumes.
Oh my god!
Wants to try
that. I know they want to.
Yeah, I'm going to take a picture.
Oh, this is great.
You got it.
There you go.
Where are you passing?
What a great opportunity to start putting this up.
I think that's Mattress. Oh, what fun. That's a good
one. So this is what they're going to do on the day of. Just hold up. Hold me up. Here we go.
Okay, hold it again.
Going
up and down. There you go. Perfect. Now dance.
Dancing now.
Oh, it's going right on the website. High school.
track and field country, right? The track and field team, their first year that they did this, they made $3,900 on a day, which is pretty solid, right? The second year that they did this, $3,700. So I went up to them and I said, you know what, if you really want to knock it out, you really got to talk, it's all about personal referrals. You can take 10,000 flyers, throw it in 10,000 cars. It's not going to have to be effective, but like if your little niece or nephew calls you up and asks you to do something, how likely are you to refer to a flyer that's underneath your windshield? So they kind of got it, so when they did, $6,500. So they can't wait to do that. Same thing with Walt Bull, football team. $3,500 that first year. They just did it again back in July, $7,100. So that would help a little bit, right? So our goal is $7,500 to $10,000. Everybody has the same $10,000 opportunity. In order to make $7,500 or $4,000, if we want to make $10,000, we need to sell for about 70 to 80 days. Of those 2,500 people, we need to get 70 to 80 people. That's it.
I think it's important to know, too, that Jack's invested a lot in us. How many guys did you send to the middle school that Jack printed for us?
I think to the feeder schools, including the middle school, the elementary schools, that's over, 1,200 kids?
I think it is 25, right?
Yeah.
2,500.
You know, it's... We spent the whole day in class folding envelopes and sending them out. We had some kids actually go to the schools and talk to the principals. So, you know, we're... So, Jack challenged us to get 75 adults in here, and if we got 75 parents in here, we get a check for $500. So, CFS is helping us out a lot with this whole thing, so I just want to...
Yes, it does, nothing comes, they don't pay for it, none of the postage, no flyer, no poster, no sign, no banner, $0 to them. So we take on all their financial, it's not really a risk. It is if you don't follow the steps, which is just talk to people that you know. The last thing I'll leave you with is if you have your cell phones or make sure, this is really cool, this will help too. Everybody, if you know how to text, you can do it right now.
It's super easy because the students will tell you, I hand my phone over to them for everything. It's like, just do it for me, please. And Jack tested me and told me what to text.
Why don't you tell them about it?
Okay. All right. But I actually did it on my own. So Jack texted me. Okay, so he said, open a new text message. He opened a new text message. Come on, get it. I know you have your phone. Okay, thumbs up when you're ready. Okay, and then dial 67076. 67076. Everybody there? 076. And then in the text area, just DECA, DECA. And it said. Oh, wait.
There's that. It's in here also.
Oh, it's the auditorium. Okay, so when you go out the door. Okay, hold it over here, that way it works. And then, so then you just said, please share this information so you have a list. And this is the cool part, we're still.
Nope. No.
Oh, she had to scoop it up. So it should look, it looks like that. And if you click, it still starts talking to you.
Hit the talk button, and you're going to hear a message from her. 30 seconds. She's going to tell you what to do.
What to do in 67076. 67076. So why? And then there's another button that you click that says share. And if you click that, it takes you off. Watch me. Automatically. And it'll allow you to share with all your friends on Facebook. Yeah. I had eight coming. I showed Jack. I was like, ooh, eight puppies.
That was so easy. How far?
No, it was super. Honestly, I was like, okay. So we'll be doing that as a class action tomorrow. I'm sure that all gets out there. But Jack's investing in us. So if you can really encourage your kids and their friends who couldn't make it here today because they were on the soccer field or in the volleyball or over at our Babson College course, if you can just encourage everybody, we sent out 284 letters to potential DECA members. So there are another another 100 kids out there that have this opportunity. And even if they're not sure if they want to compete, it still pays for our trips, our hospitality trips to go see the Celtics and talk to the marketing agents of the Celtics. That happens in December. It helps pay for things like Lasergate team building or the ropes course team building. It helps pay for when we go to the Red Sox and meet with the administration and marketing agents of the Red Sox in the spring. What am I forgetting? Help pay for at the States, and you already heard your kids tell you they're going out to Anaheim. So to help pay for Anaheim too. So I don't know, I don't want to take away from Jack.
Well, that's it. I'm going to hang back here if anybody does have any questions. Does anybody have any questions right now at the top of your head that you have that I can help answer?
Do people
want to
buy mattresses one day?
It's designed to be a one-day event to maximize the opportunity for them to get the most money. Some of you not make it there, we totally get that. So it happens a lot. Actually, at East Creek, at Bridgewater Raider High School, 3 weeks ago, the band, they made $8,500. They had seven people that came after that event. They came to another event because they couldn't make it. So they did. So you can actually go to this coming Saturday. I'm calling it Pembroke here. You can actually go there. And you can actually see how much go to where. And we will do that. After where it after your investment, the one after that, if you go on to the events, you'll see that all the ones that are coming up. If you go to the one after that, I forget where we're at. We have so many. Every week, sometimes we do two on Saturday and Sunday. But you guys go to another event and just say, I want this to go to DECA to wear him, and they'll get the credit, and the student will get the referral and everything.
So that's the great part, because you're sharing that website anyway, so people will be like, oh, well, I can't make that weekend, but let's not lose a sale.
Yeah. Just last weekend, tomorrow night, I'm going to Foxborough High School to deliver field hockey. They're checked tomorrow night. They just had their event 2 weeks ago. 31 girls that played field hockey, 55 mattresses sold, $8,600.
So guys, and that's what I told the kids, we're marketing students. Most of us are athletes too, and drama students and everything else, but first and foremost, it's DECA, we're marketing students. We should be out there promoting and selling like there's no tomorrow. And we should be able to hit their goal. It's just them making sure they get home and talk to everybody about it. And us all doing our job to share it as well. So,
65 kids. So, like I said, I'll be back here. If anybody does have any questions, then I'll hand it back to you for any last questions. Thanks, everybody.
But on behalf of Wareham DECA and the whole school, we want to thank Jack and Preston Fundraising Solutions for everything they're doing and how easy they're making it for us. You know, all we're doing is just going out and spreading the word. They've, you know, gotten us all the information, all the tools that we need, from flyers we're handing out to students, to kids, the yard flyers, posters, that you are all going to get and take home. Hopefully hang them up over there. Hopefully hang them up or do whatever you want with them when you get home. So nothing else that I want to say, or if you want to...
No, so just, it's an opportunity for your kids to make a ton of money really easily. And you don't have to buy anything. That's the key. You don't have to buy anything. We're hoping to do what Jackie showed us that other schools have done in making this a tradition. This is our weekend. Forevermore. We'd love to be the ones breaking that record. And we should be able to. We have to just get our feet wet. Yes.
So if someone does come to the event and does do a financing offer, how does that student school turn get that money? Is that right away or
very late. Because we still pay the school and the student.
So that's the key too. What I thought was great back in March is that we don't wait months to get our money. Jack comes back in 2 weeks. And starts throwing, he's like, yeah, I'll just give it to the kids. I was like, oh, no, it's going back down. Yes.
We have a logistics
question. We deliver everywhere. I actually had a buddy of mine who does this in Philadelphia. There's a student, I guess, she moved here to Boston, and we delivered for him. So if you know somebody who lives in Philadelphia or anywhere else, they can actually go to an event out there, and they can set up delivery with them at their city. We also go, it's designed for the where in the surrounding communities, but we deliver to Cape Cod, New Hampshire, Maine, anywhere.
So that's anywhere. The key when he tells us to brainstorm that brainstorming activity. Do you know somebody that runs a little bed and breakfast or a little motel or those houses of real estate? That's where we want to get our niche though.
We had somebody from a school up in North Shore in Salem High School. She came in about 15 beds and she was remodeling her small inn. She bought 15 beds, so it's out there. Norwood High School, even just Norwood High School, Braintree High School, just recently at Bridgewater Arena. A few firemen came in. We actually doubled the discount for them, as well as the teachers. But they bought 15 at Bridgewater Arena, 19 at Norwood, 19 at Braintree. I just got a college tip for another 15 at for a hospital. So we make them for everybody, because everybody sleeps on a mattress.
So if anybody has the backbone to the fire station, we did drop off flyers, but if you have the backbone and have a connection?
It will help them, but every 2 or 3 years or 4 years, they rotate out their mattresses. I don't know how many are here. It could be their time. It's all about timing. We're not here to push anything on anybody. It's all non-salesy, non-pushy. We're just here to, it's a community social fun environment. If you are in the market yourselves, please come check it out. You'll be surprised what we have. Same mattresses in the store, same warranties, but the customer service is a lot better. And the money saves are located in this community that you love.
And lastly, just so you know, any of the senior DECA members or the business principals kids, we have made, because it's a vocational marketing program, this is an assessment. If they want a promotion, they can either write a paper or they can show up for 2 hours. We made the shift short so that they're not going to get iced coffees or hot coffees. We just work for 2 hours and 15 minutes and we're good. But they'll be placed all over Wareham. Ms. Kelly, Ms. Glaze, Sylvan and I will be going around checking on everybody all the time. 2 hours, they're never by themselves. They're in a team of 2, 3, or 4, depending. The seniors identify 10 key. Sorry. Okay. 10 key locations in town, everywhere from the Rotary straight over to, I think, we go as far west as the Walmart.
Yes.
That would be Cypress. Okay. So that's what they'll be doing that day. First shift, I think, starts at 8:45. Because Jack's people are taking care of sales. Their kids aren't selling. They're just running. And we have banners, like you said. So I want people to encourage them and make them stretch. Some of them are classmen aren't used to doing this. Our classmen are used to doing different fun, cookie things like this. Drag them out for a lot of stuff. But it's their opportunity to do hands-on. And one last thing, they can put it on their resumes. He's a project manager.
video?
So we have one, so we want to thank Jack, and also we have 3 more minutes for the County Federal Teachers Union and other partners that came to see us, who employs our kids. But Jack, anything else?
I'm good. Thanks, everybody.
For those of you that don't know me, my name is Marie Garvey. I'm working at the Plymouth County Teachers Federal Credit Union on the West Grand Am. PCT credit union is a little easier. And the reason why we picked it is because last October, PCT opened a little main branch credit union right there in high school. It's really exciting. And the whole purpose of it was to coordinate with the kids and to collaborate with the kids in the Wayham Public Schools. And we have myself and other people working in the branch, but we also have students coming to work in our branch right here at the high school and also at our branch in West Virginia. So it's pretty exciting when we introduce ourselves to you and let you know what's happening. As far as PCT, we take care of all your banking needs. As far as the students, we have savings and checking accounts, so they get debit cards. If they want to open an account, if you become a member of the credit union, it's $5. So the students will pay that $5 to have to open the account, and when that money stays in their account for a year, then it becomes their money. But of course, in the meantime, it cards up the same for different things. A couple of things we want to mention. For the students, and I will show them what's one. When you are a member of PCT, then you qualify for 2 schools, college scholarships that we have. So that's encouraging because you're juniors and seniors, and another couple scholarship opportunities. We have a young man, some of you may know, Joe Nash, who actually started working with us as an intern a couple summers ago, worked in our branch here, worked in our branch in West Wayham, was a marketing intern, so there's opportunities for that. The scholarships. There's more information in the brochure. The dual enrollment loans. A lot of students now, junior and seniors, are eligible to take classes at Bridgewater State College. And there is a small fee, but for some it might be enough to hold them back. We are going to offer loans now. So low interest loans, so the kids can take out a small loan, a line of credit, so they can help avoid paying for the classes at Bridgewater State College. So lots of exciting things for the kids. The branch is open 11 to 1, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right next to the cafeteria. It is actually open to the public, if you guys want to come by and show your license to Mrs. Munson, she'll give you a pass, you can come down and do banking right here, as well as the students. And as far as the adults, we offer, again, all kinds of banking programs, we offer loan programs, we have very competitive rates, we have a great visa, where the lowest rate is low as 9.9%, so lots to offer, we're very excited to be in the school working with the kids, and please stop by, and thank you for having us.